Look at the recording icon over there. I'm now starting the next session. So go to the share screen and go back to on it. So the previous session has already been uploaded. I will now show you and go back to on it. So I will now go to the drive.google.com. And then I will now click on the, you have to click on the share with me on the left hand side. Whereas I am not going to, I'm not sharing. I will not look on it. So you have to click on the share with me and then this will be coming. Open it up. And then if you go there, every session will be uploaded in the inventory PO records. If you go there, fine, double click on it. I will now upload it. So the 04 financial setups final is uploaded. And then the fifth session will be uploaded after this is completed. So it will now keep on getting uploaded. So download and then watch each. There is a correction video also, fine. Also watch this. It will now give you a good idea. So anybody has got stuck, it is now giving you a guideline and then try to correct the problems now. Fine. If you are able to correct the problems, you've got a very good, excellent diagnostic skills actually. Now, Sanjay Das has sent me one thing now, fine with that. So I will now open up, fine, Sanjay Das. I will now download it, fine. This document I'm going to upload in web space actually, fine. Download for a bill account, fine, is one. So he's now given it. So here I will now go to my, there is a directory here now.
Maybe this is more relevant for order management.
Maybe.
Sales yeah. order.
Yes. So I have one web space available here. Fine, I will now save it on this place now. So go there. I will now click a save now. It's now getting saved. It's a sales order creation actually. Fine, I'm not sure what is the file name. I'll now say sales order creation fails. Fine, this orders. So let me upload it in my web space now. Fine, you want it. I will now go to my web space. It's a OneNote website. It's the one. This is my website. So here, this you will now reach by what? If you go to this place, and then if you go to this place, here in the fifth one, fine, this is the one. This is the student guides, activity guides. Fine, go click on the Word document. And then in the Word document, you'll be having this one now. If you click on this link, you will now reach this now. For this reach, for this web space, I have a write access, whereas you have only a view and then download access now. You have a view and download, whereas I have a write access because it's my space now. So let me add it up. I will now click on upload. I will now go to upload files. You cannot do that. I can only upload and do it. No, fine. Go that you want it. I will now open up. No, fine. Go that you want on. Yeah, this is the one. So there isn't one. I have to upload now. Date modified. This is the one. He has done it. Fine. Go that. Click on open now. So it is now getting uploaded. So upload is now in the process now. It has got uploaded. So you can know which it is. This is the latest one. So download all these documents also. There may be some of them will be very, oh God, I have not done it in a improper manner. I have to open it up and then upload. I will open up this one now. I will not upload. In this one, Nana Mobile, this one is a useful document. Fine. Here I upload, fine. Click on upload and then I will go to upload files. I have to upload there. Click on upload. So the uploading will start now. It is now uploading. It has now got uploaded. So here you go and then visit once in a month at least and then see what are the things which are newly coming and then you can download those things. Plenty of steps are there. So you can download those things. So this is my OneNote space actually. Good then. So we are going to continue on this now. And then one more thing which I have to explain to you. One mistake which one of my students has done in the production level now. I will tell you what exactly is done now. So you go there. You go to the setup and maintenance. Any problems after 8:30 or on Monday to Friday, you call me, we will now come and then attend to it now. Manage chart of accounts. So we go there. In this place, what he has done is I'll now click on search, blank search, and then you go to the manage structures. And then if you click on plus now, and then rather I will not give a plus now, and then you will now query on the existing one now. One of them, I will not query it. And then here, I will not. Oh, nothing has. See, these guys have not done anything at all. Just like that, they have left it. And then, if you create one segment, then it will not throw an error actually. Biggest problem. Edit it. He has got it. He has only created two segments, so it will not give a problem. So, what he has done is this place, he has given one extra space here. One extra space has been given on the segment code. And it was throwing an error. And then we are unable to understand why the error is coming up. Afterwards, one of the financial guys told that because of this extra space, fine. Don't give any extra space in the segment code. No, fine. It's a very important one. And if you give extra space, it will not throw some error during transactional size. And the warning, because we face this problem, and then immediately somebody came in, and then they what happens? They suggested the solution actually. The extra space was there.
So Nana, how could we fix this? Because it's non-editable.
Yeah, edit and then do it. And then if it is not possible, you have to take the help of technique. The code cannot be edited actually. Fine, code cannot be edited, but there are some workarounds now. Fine, financial teams knows it now. And if you give an extra space, financial team will now help you to what happens, remove the space also. that extra space can be removed. Because it is an uneditable field, remember. It's a very important one. Because we face the issue on this. So we are now completed that what's called this service provider client functionality is a very big one. And then you will not do it. And then later on, you will be doing it. You will now gradually understand it. Now we will jump into inventory setups now. We'll now go there. We'll now begin the inventory setups. Fine, take a copy of it. Manage facility shifts is the first one. Fine. We are now completing the business unit setups. We are now going to go for the business unit for the inventory setups. Click on it. I will now go to the search now. I will now go to the paste the task. Enter now. Manage facility shifts is the first one. Fine. I'll now go there. Click on it. I'll now do it. Now click on plus. I'm now going to get a facility shift now. I will now say it's a G03 facility shift. So you will not discuss with the end client about how the shift is going to operate upon. And take off it and then put a description. So we'll now give what happens a G03. Is a three-letter code or something like that. Shift start time. I will now say 8 a.m. Then duration is now going to work for 8 hours. We'll click on it. And then I'll now say hours. And then category is a work from home or work from office. I'll now say it now. And then shift detail time. What happens? Please don't put flexible now. Flexible will work only for flow manufacturing. I remember. Fine. And then punch also will not work for manufacturing. None it has to be. For fusion manufacturing, it has to be none now. Flexible will not work for manufacturing. And then there are certain things are there. Make the shift detail is none actually. Punch, we need labor management actually. For a labor management, only punch will work. If you don't have a labor management, don't choose it. Otherwise, what happens? You choose none. None will work for generic ones now. Fine, give it. So you have to create multiple shifts.
I have flexible don't work.
Yeah, flexible will not work at all for manufacturing. If you make it as a flexible, manufacturing will not work at all. Manufacturing, only for flow manufacturing, flexible will work. And then it is yet to come in for fusion now. Only process manufacturing has come, flow manufacturing is yet to come in now. Right? They have made it now. And then once when the flow manufacturing comes in, it will now start to work for that flow manufacturing.
In coming updates, flexible would be coming?
Yeah. It's going to come in. They're going to, that's why they have already put it now. Fine. There, it is under development process now. Fine. In one of the releases, it will be coming.
Okay.
We faced the problem and then we identified it actually. In one of the places, we are unable to set up the manufacturing and then it was flexible actually. One second, I'm just a small work, 5 minutes, I'll not pause the. Okay, fine. So in this place, fine, flex punches for labor management, it is yet to come. And then a flexible will work only for flow manufacturing. None, you choose it. Discrete and process will work definitely. Give a save and close. And then if the client is operating on 3 shifts, create that many shifts over here now. All the shifts you have to create. Thank you, save and close. By which the facility shift is created. Are you hearing me? Anybody? Is it my audible voice?
Yes,
audible?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Click on that now. So we go for the next step. So facility shift is now created. Now we go for the workday patterns. 31st step is workday pattern. I will not take a copy of it. I go there. I will not paste it over here. So manage facility workday patterns. Click on it. You're going to do it. So click on plus, I'll be creating it. So it's a G01, G03 actually, fine. Workday pattern I'm going to create. So take a copy of it and then click on it. And then in the initial stage of release 11, I have given 5 days of working. And then order management was unable to ship on the holidays actually. In EVIS also, we have the same thing. If the workday pattern is a holiday, he cannot ship it. So we also face a similar problem. And then so from an order management perspective, we have to make it a 7 days, remember. Right? We cannot ship the product if any day is a holiday. It is same in EBIS as well as in Fusion also. Make it a 7 days and go there, click on it. And then click on add row. And then in the add row, I'm going to add the workday pattern details. Fine, go there. I will now say start day is 1 and then end day is 7. Go there. And then shift name is G03. This is the shift name I'm going to put it now. If there are multiple shifts, you have to add plus, and then you add it. So go there, click on it. So it is okay. And everything is now coming. At what timing it's working. So the workday pattern is now created. Any doubts on this now?
One question. Length in days can be 6 days. Length in days can be 6 days.
Length, if you make it a 6 days, the 7th day, we cannot ship at all. Remember. On the 7th day, we cannot ship. Fine. Shipping is not allowed on a holiday, actually. Fine. Make it a 7 days. We face the problem. Probably the
bug. No, we can edit after that, right?
Maybe. See, I edited it. I was doing an implementation of an order management way back, some 2 years back. At the time, we faced the problem. I raised the SR. They immediately asked me to make it a 7.
Sir, here you put timing also, no? Sir, so after, before...
Timing is not important. Timing is 24 hours, remember. Whatever time you put, it is only 8 hours now, fine, go there. 8 a.m. to 4 p.m., but it allows shipping 24 hours now. but it is sensitive for the days only and not for the time actually. 24 hours shipping is possible, but if a day is a holiday, it was not allowing. Probably the bug might have got fixed. I'm not sure about it, but I'm always teaching on this now. Right? Afterwards, I never implemented anything. I'm going there. Timing is not important, but number of days is important. Probably if there is a bug, then you can even put 5 days also. Okay.
Now, this timing is for what capacity planning?
Timing is what the planning central actually. Right? The planning central has got three modules, the demand planning, supply planning, and then sales and operations planning. That will be honoring this time actually. Let us say I'm going to manufacture a monitor at the rate of 100 monitors per hour. And then if it's 8 hours work, then what happens? It will now sense that it can only manufacture 800 monitors. So if a customer is asking 2000 monitors today, it will say, I will ship 800 today, another 800 tomorrow, and then the balance on the third day. So for the planning central to give a, what's called a, the scheduled ship date, right, an assurance on the fulfillment, it will now do the calculation actually. So it has to be exact as per the client working actually, remember. Inventory has got no problem. Whatever timings you give, inventory will now ship 24 hours actually. All inventory activities will now work irrespective of the number of days. Only order management cannot ship on a holiday. It was at the time. So that is how it's working now. Fine with that.
Nana, yeah. If the shift is for 24 hours and it is divided into three, then we will add
we have to add all the shifts over here now.
Okay, thanks.
So that's where we define day one as Monday or Sunday.
Yeah, is a good question. Day one is a Monday. I will not see. Fine. Day one is Monday or Sunday. Fine. Okay, save and close. Fine. And then maybe in the next one, we may be defining it, I think. Fine. The next screen.
So,
from
the planning perspective, it will not consider this 7 days work calendar.
Yeah, you should not make it. But again, you have to talk to the planning team now. Fine. How they are compromising on this now. Fine. Maybe this is a bug when release 11 was come out. And then they have now, I think something might have happened. I'm not very sure about it now. So have a look at the workday pattern with the current one now. Now the facility schedules is the final one now. So you created a shift and then inserted into the workday pattern, and then the workday pattern will be inserted into schedules actually. Yeah, tell me, somebody is having a problem.
Will you share this sheet or you have already uploaded in the SharePoint?
Hey, come on. You should not ask such a basic question. No, if you go to this place, if you go to drive.google.com.
Yeah, got it.
Go to drive.google.com and then click on the share with me left, open it up. The sheet is already there here. You can see.
Okay.
So this, what I'm as inventory fusion worksheet. Right?
Okay. Thank you.
That means what you're not even started practicing basically. Right? So the sheet is.
No, I have downloaded, but.
Forgotten it. Okay. Doesn't matter. So it's all right. So we go there and then we'll now paste this now. Right? Manage facility shifts. Schedules now. Right? Click on schedules. Now. He was asking which is the one. Control is not compass. And then here, by default, it gives you only 1 day actually. We had another problem on this. So it's only 1 day. So the effective start date will be that this is the day one, I think, probably. This is the day one, I think. Whatever date you are giving it, that will be date one. And then give 4 or 5 years now. Fine with that.
No, there is a start weekday and it says Monday. So this will be the day one, first day of week. Here it is mentioned Monday.
Press the space bar and speak now. Fine, this is what I'm saying.
Yeah, are you able to hear me? The first day of the week, it is saying Monday. So here, day one will be that.
Medium. Okay, right. This is the start day. Right? So based upon it, if you're giving a 5 day, what happens, it'll be coming. And then talk to the planning central team also about how it is resolved on the shipping of order management as well as this one. I'm not sure about it. What is the present status? And then give an effective date for five years now. Fine, if you want it, I will not put a 5 years. 21-25. And later on also, you can increase it. Now. The quarterly. This is very important from a planning perspective. If you give a 4-4-5 week pattern, the 1st of January to 28th of January is first month. From 29th of January to next 4 weeks is next month. And then afterwards, 5 weeks. So a quarter has got 13 weeks. And then that will be, and the year has got 52 weeks. So this is the way the planning section will be doing it now. So how they wanted to make the first month, second month, third month based upon 445 or 454 or 544, that will be decided by the planning now. So give it like this. But if planning central module is now sold, this 13 period and monthly will not work at all. So always choose one of them. It has got no relevance to inventory procurement and order management. Only for the planning, it is very important for that. Accordingly, do it. So give it. And then category, I know, make it as what work now.
What would be the impact if we choose quarterly time as 13 or something?
Yeah. 13 periods means what? It is a 13 month, and then planning cannot plan at all. Planning cannot plan. Monthly also, it cannot plan.
So in case of planning, we have something called as forecasting and scheduling.
Uh-huh.
So what happens is we will not be able to see how the demand is going to be fulfilled or how supplies would be matched to the demand over a shorter, smaller time frame, like a week or day kind of a thing. So
what is your
that
name?
Is the reason.
What is your name?
So my name is Chandrasekhar.
Chandrasekhar from US. No, fine. You are from US.
Canada.
Canada. Okay, Canada.
Yeah.
So Chandra from Canada is now saying that what happens, it has to, for the forecasting purposes, it is required on the planning front. Have you implemented planning?
Yeah, I had been working only on planning for the past 14 years.
What is your name, full name in the WhatsApp now?
Chandrasekhar Narayanan.
Okay, Chandrasekhar Narayanan is the name in the WhatsApp. So if you have any queries on the planning, you can talk to him. He has implemented it also. Right? So this, he says that for the demand forecasting, this is to be one of the periods actually. Right? That's what he's saying. And any more further updates, he will not give you. He can talk to you.
A month is also equal to 4 weeks.
No. Month is not 4 weeks now. Actually, month is February has got
20. Actual month.
Yes. Mm. Actual month. It is actual month, and that varies actually. Planning will not be able to plan on a monthly or 13 periods. Remember, planning to plan, you need this one of them as such. So go there, click on plus now. I'm going to add a workday pattern over here now. If I click on it, I will not add a workday pattern. So
while using that quarterly type, we can our inventory periods also will be based on that, right?
Nothing. Inventory has got no periods in Fusion, remember. Inventory has got periods in Ibis. Inventory do not have any periods, and then it has got nothing to do with the inventory periods at all. Inventory has got no periods, remember.
Okay.
Nana, planning, is it MRP in Ibis?
In Ibis it is ACP.
ACP.
Is there, and then we have a separate planning also. Another AACP is planning, of course. AACP is planning.
None on this side, Vinay. In R12, there is MRP and AACP. Both MRP is the smaller one.
Not sold at all to the customers now. Fine. Oracle has stopped selling MRP. Whatever Whoever is existing having it, then they will do it. Otherwise, new MRP sales is not there at all in Oracle. Only AACP they are selling now. Once again. Okay, fine. So we are now attached the workday pattern to our schedule actually. I will now say this is a G3 schedule. I'll put the schedule now, fine. Schedule. And then go there. Take a copy of it and then put it in the description. And then click on save and close. Now our schedule is made now. So it's now giving a warning. If the schedule start date is not the first day of a week, a partial first day period of the workday pattern will be generated. Do you want to continue? It doesn't matter now. So he's now giving you some warning. This is all important only from a planning perspective and not from an inventory perspective, actually.
How to control these government holidays?
Yeah, you have to only announce an exception over there now. Fine, go there, click on it, and then do it. So you will be doing a big digging on the workday pattern once when you go for planning, actually, and not for other modules. Other modules is very simple, actually. Other execution modules, fine, like inventory, procurement, order management, and then other things, they're all execution modules, supply chain execution modules. There, the calendar is not much of a importance. Only for order management, if it's a holiday, it will not ship. Fine. There is another thing. Other than this, other execution modules will not look into it, calendar to a great extent, actually. So we are now completed what? The facility schedules is now completed. Now we are going to create an inventory org now. Fine. Manage inventory org, I'm going to create. Fine. Go on it. I will not go on and create an inventory or. So if you see in this
for exceptions, what will be using, Nana?
Exceptions, we will not say tomorrow is a Nayantara's birthday. It's a holiday. So likewise, what happens? You will not put an exception.
No. What will be the name? Manage expectations.
I don't know. I have not done the exceptions basically. Fine. Anybody? Maybe there will be a task for exceptions.
In the manage schedule itself, there is a schedule exception, Nana.
Fine.
And then when you're working on the planning, they will not explain you a great one. When you attend the planning training, they will not do a lot of things on this now. For inventory, whatever you do, it will not work for 24 by 7 inventory. So, okay, fine. Now, here, inventory or can be anything. It may be raw material, manufacturing or a warehouse. No, yet we have.
Again, here also, do we need to do the build calendar concept here in Fusion, Nana?
No. There is no build. Who is this?
Chakravarti.
Chakravarti is asking from an e-business perspective, whenever you're creating a calendar there, you have to build. Here, no need to build at all. It gets automatically built, actually. No need to build. Okay. Building is not required as far as Fusion. Okay. They have simplified it, simplified so many things, actually.
Thank you.
So go there. And then we'll not come to this place now. So we are going to create an inventory org. The inventory org is nothing but it may be a raw material stores, it may be a manufacturing unit, it may be warehouse. So all these things are inventory orgs. So we are going to create two inventory or three inventory orgs now. One is a master org and then two child orgs we are going to create. We'll go there. So let's go there and create it. Manage inventory org is the one. Paste it over here. Entering on. Now we're going to create it. Click on the manage inventory org. We're not creating it. So click on plus and then I'm going to create it. We'll be creating it. So we'll go there. So first of all, I'll create a master org. Master org is nothing but a repository of all item definitions. We will not perform any transactions in the master at all. Items will be created in the master and then kept as a repository actually. So we'll be creating a master actually over there. So let's go there, click on this. I will now say G03 underscore master org. I'm now creating it. So take a copy of it and then click on the organization code now. Organization code has to start with capitals actually. Capital G03 and then I will now say 0. So in my convention, 0 is a master org. And then again, when you go to the field, you have a, what's called the naming convention designed or rather approved by your client actually. You give the name and then the code, this is the organization code. Everything you write and then give them. After getting approval, you create it. Right? Because certain things cannot be modified later on. So usage is inventory management. You go there. Your business unit is
one. Nana, sir, one query. Organization code is of how many characters?
In eBiz, it's only 3 characters. Here, it is 18 characters actually.
Oh, that's great. Thank you.
G03, give a tab now. So once you give a tab, the business unit is going to come now. Fine, go there. So G03 and then I give a tab. Otherwise, you drop it down and choose it. So the location, fine, go there. G03, I will now put the 0th location now. Fine, go there. 0th location. And remember, one location to one org only. In eBiz, it is not so. We can assign the location to multiple orgs also. Here it is not possible. One location to one org only, you have to do it. So the 0th one. Right? If you assign the location to some other org, your supply chain transactions, some of the transactions will fail actually, remember. Don't do it. Right? One location to one org is a must actually. And then put the legal entity over here. The profit center based entity will be coming automatically. I'll be discussing about it a bit later now, when you're discussing about the profit center actually. So now what happens is that if you go on and see this now, this one is into LE, Y1. LEBU combination actually.
Anna, tell me. If one business unit has 3 orgs, manufacturing, trading, and maintenance, then we have to give same locations to the every organization.
No, you should not give. Let us say all the 3 organizations are in Madras only. So
yeah,
physical locations are same, but you create 3 distinct logical locations and assign it to individuals.
Okay, so what is the impact if we are giving
the location? It will not fail. That is it. Fine. Your transactions, some transactions will pass, some transactions will fail if you put the same location for every org. I don't know which one will fail, but we have seen that failure actually.
But, so okay. Nana, in being the Chennai, I'm having the 3 location. Yeah. Then I have to create the 3 location for the 3 different inventory org?
Situated physically, the postal addresses are the same, but logically there must be 3 locations now. Fine. Lock 1, lock 2, lock 3, like a Madras 1, Madras 2, Madras 3, like that you have to create it.
So Nana, do you having idea of this, which transaction will be failing?
I don't know. We have faced the failure. Fine. I have not seen the failure. And then way back, some 5 years back in release 9, we raised the SR. Then they told, because we are all coming from EBIS perspective, we are unable to understand why it's failing. Then Oracle immediately told, oh no, it is not so in Fusion. Fine, you have to have a distinct location. Fine. I forgot on that actually, which transaction failed. But you don't do this now. Don't do experiment on this. Remember, I am again and telling you, don't experiment. It will fail. Certain things will fail actually. Some will pass, some will fail actually. Go there. So 0th location is now done. Fine, click on next now. Click on next. You go to the next one.
Yeah, when you have 3 locations in Chennai, so which one will be master and which one will be the child?
Now I am now going to decide this as a master now. So I'm not going to decide this as a master. To make it as a master, you put the same name over here now. Fine, go there. Click on it. If you put the same name, it becomes a master. If you put a different name, it becomes a child lecture. This org and this org are different. This org is a child org. This and this are same. This is a master org. That is the way you design. Got it now?
What is the significance in real business?
You are all electing me as a union leader now. Fine. So once when you elect as a union leader, what I will do, I will now, you will also put a token and then come into the factory and then you will work. I will also put the token and then come, but I will not work. I will know when is your promotion due, when is your retirement, when is your other benefits. I will know, have the complete details of you. And then I will now represent the management and then I will not work because I'm a union leader. And no department, I will be associating to one maintenance department just for namesake. But the maintenance department will not give me any work at all because I'm a union leader.
Nana, one question.
So once again, similarly, the master org is a repository of all item definitions and then no transactions in the master table. You will not perform any transactions in the master org. Yeah, tell me.
Nana, one question. You are using the managed inventory org for the creation of the master org. But there is also a provision to create the master org from the master item organization that you are creating item organization itself. Why you are not using that
part? We will come to that part a bit later. Now, fine. Item organizations for CRM module and not for supply chain. Okay, fine. You are not supposed to create it. Don't do it now. Do not create item org. Create only an inventory org. Item org is a CRM. I will not show you the problem and then I will not rectify the problem.
In this regard,
default IMO in product item, he is talking about that.
No, no. Why you are not? We'll come to that a bit later. Now, fine. He was talking about item org.
IMO.
Actually. No, it is not IMO. He was talking about item org. Item org is not IMO. This is IMO.
In Fusion, there are two types of organization. One is item organization, another is inventory organization.
Inventory org is for supply chain, remember.
Okay. Now, there is a new concept called reference organization. Can you tell something about...
Let us now gradually learn, not jump into each and everything immediately. Now. I will now come.
No, I didn't know that this is not the time.
We'll be teaching everything now. And let us now gradually learn. Now. Fine. We are now in the beginning stage of the inventory. Now. We'll now teach each and everything. I will not teach you about item.
In this case, you are recommending that when you are creating the inventory organization, select the item organization as the same organization name.
No,
right?
No. Item organization, we are not supposed to do.
No. In this LOB, what are you going to select?
I am going to select the same org. If I am selecting the
you
same
are going to select. That was my question only.
Nana, this is Vasu. I think we should have question answer sessions at some point. Your flow is getting disturbed.
After the topic, that would be better, Nana.
Yes.
After the topic, yeah.
Teaching is always systematic and methodical. Fine. I will never skip anything at all. Fine. Remember? And then at the appropriate place, I will be introducing it. No, fine. So once when the inventory goes to a certain extent, afterwards you shoot your questions, I will answer it. No, fine. As of now, I have not discussed anything on the item org. And then I'm not only giving the inventory org. And then I have not told about the reference org and definition org. We'll definitely be doing it. No, fine. Don't worry. As of now, do exactly what I'm doing now. Fine. So go there, click on it. And then here, I'm not going to make the start revision as ZA now. Fine. Revision, I'm not making a start revision. Fine. Go there. So I'm now put the same org. So once when I put this org as this org becomes the master org now. This is a master org. And I'm putting the same org for that. Schedule, I will now go there. G03 is a schedule. Fine, give it a tab now. I'm putting it up. Click on search now. It's not coming. Tell me. G03. I'm doing it now. I'm putting my schedule over there. If the schedule has got flexible or anything on the workday patterns, fine. It will not work at all for your manufacturing actually. Inventory, it will work. But for manufacturing, it will not work. And then the locator control, I drop it down and then choose it as what? Locator control determined at subinvent level. This is the one I'm going to choose now. Right? Locator control determined at subinvent level, you choose it. We're discussing about it a bit later now. So these are the modifications I'm doing it. I'm not going to this tab region as well as I'm not going to this tab region. And then there are some mandatory fields. If it is asking for, like what happened, the starting serial number there. If the mandatory fields is not filled, you fill it up now. You go there. Here also, what happens? I'm not doing anything. I go there. Click on save and close by which what happens? My inventory master org is created now.
Nana, just one thing. Allow negative balances is checked.
I will come to it a bit later. No, fine. I will not complete. When we are going in depth, deep dive into inventory, I will not complete. No, as of now,
Nana, can I ask question related to item master organization only?
Tell me.
There are two legal entities, and these two legal entities are entirely different. One is Reliance Petrol, and another one is the GEO. both are under the same org. So how we are creating it?
Both legal entities are going to use the same chart of accounts. We can share the master actually. Again, the advanced concept, I will be discussing about it a bit later. Since you asked for it, let us say there are 5 legal entities are there. All of them are using the same chart of accounts. Then we can have, it is Oracle is strongly recommending to have only one master across all the 5 LLEs.
From the IMO point of view, it's for the single or for the each LOB, we can create different IMO. That is the only question.
IMO is not created, remember. IMO is mentioned in the inventory org. If you mention it, this becomes a master org for this org. If these two are same, this itself is a master
org. No. From G03 master org, so for the 5 different legal entities, we have to create 5 different master organizations.
Just about it a bit later. No, fine, there's an advanced one. Fine. After 8:30 or any other day, what happens, you come, I will not discuss about it. Fine, I will not tell you about it. Fine. As of now, this is not much of an importance for this. No, fine, because I think we'll now have a discussion later. No, fine. So this is not done. Fine. Click on save and close. I have now completed the master org creation. No. Fine, click on save and close now. Now I'm going to create 2 child orgs for this exercise. No, fine. So if you go and then give G03 and then query for it now, fine, you'll now find the master over here. Master is mentioned, master is not created, remember. Inventory org is only created, master org is not created actually. So click on plus now. I will now go and then create my child inventory org. So G01_child_1, I'm going to create now. So my nomenclature is what? Capital G03. I will now put my G03 business.
G03 or G01?
G03, sir.
Oh, sorry, this is G03. Sorry. The mistake actually, fine, G03. Because I am conducting another training there and then I am getting confused on this now. G03, give a tab now. I will now put the location number 1 now. Legal entity, drop it down. Automatically, these two are there. The legal entity becoming more, then click on it. And then status is active. Fine, go back to on. Dispatch is sufficient. And then click on next now. Fine. So click on next. And then, yeah, I'm going to make it as a child now. Fine, go back to on it. So to make it as a child, I have to mention a different master. Then it becomes a child actually. Fine, go back to on it. I will now say G03. And then give a tab now. I will now put the master over here. So once when I put a master, this org becomes a child org. When this and this are different, it is a child org. If this and this are same, it is a master org. So it's not that. The item behavior is what? Definition. And then we'll now come to this discussion later. Make it as a definition now. Make it as a definition. And then here, start revision is A. I will now put the schedule as G03. And then give it a tab now. Drop it down. Those who don't know, the higher level discussions are also happening. Please ignore it. Fine. Doesn't matter. We will be discussing about those higher level points later actually. Since they are asking, I'm answering it, but we will be discussing later. Fine. Do not forget to put it. We faced a problem in Dubai. Our guy has forgotten and then he has put as a no control org. We have to cancel the org and then create a new org. They were shouting like anything. It's a car manufacturing company. And then make it as locator control determinant subunit level. Otherwise, later on, you cannot make a change at all. The changes are not possible. Others. So in the beginning itself, we make it like this. Locator control determinant sub-level, whenever we're creating it, always create like this now. That is the best control level recommended by org actually, or Oracle actually. Oracle is recommending locator control determinant sub-level is the best level. Later on, you cannot make a change if you make it like this now. This is the best method. So it's not that. That's it. We go on and save by which my child org is created. I call it as a child because it has got a different master actually. If both are save, I will not say this is a master actually. Click on save now. So my first child is created. If you go on and search, it will be coming. I will now go on and create my second child now. Click on plus now. I will now go to have 2 childs now. I will now say organization what G03_child_2. If I'm making it, really correct me now. G03.
Nana sir, there is no settings in lot control or serial control or additional information. There is no settings here.
There is no settings. He is now asking. What about the settings? He is now referring EBIS actually. Fine, don't worry about it. In EBIS, we have this. It has got some capital G0. Please mute your mics. G032. So G03, go there. G03, and then give a tap. And then come in. Fine, go there. G03, and then give a tap. And that's the one. The second door I'm putting in. The second location. So every location has to have a distinct what happens assignment over there. Fine. Drop it down and then make the legal entity. The profits of the business will be coming automatically. Click on next now. Go there. And then I define a different org, then this becomes a child actually.
Nana, what is profit business center unit?
No, not now. We'll be discussing about it later. Now. Profit center business unit will be discussed about it later. Now. I'll now make the start division as A now. And then schedule is G03. But whatever I'm not discussing, we'll be discussing it later, or I may not be knowing it at all. If I don't know, also, I will not be discussing about it now. Whatever I know, I'll be discussing it later. You ask, it doesn't matter. I'll know later. So the second child org is created because it is having a different mass, different org here. If this and this are different, it is a child org. And click on save and close.
So we created one master.
How I will determine that how many child org I need and why I need a child org?
First of all, draw this diagram. You will now go to the client's location and then say how many orgs are there. Accordingly, you will now create that many child orgs. If you are having some 10 orgs, you will now create 10 child. So you are going to map the client's functionality into the Oracle system actually.
And if I don't make a master, all make a child org, then what will be happen? Because all are the different raw material manufacturing, all are the different. I will make three different org. Why I need a child org? What is the advantage of having a child?
Child org. Manufacturing is a child org. Warehouse is a child org. Transactions are made only on the child org and not on the master org. Master org is nothing but a repository of all item definitions and then no transactions in the master, remember. Got it? Okay. So you're going to map the client's way of operating his business, and then you're going to map it in the Oracle system.
So, Nana, quick question. So, master org will be only one in the entire ERP implementation time.
No. See, there are five legal entities are there. Right? And every legal entity has got a different chart of accounts. We have to have five masters. If all the legal entities are operating upon the same COE, we have the flexibility of having only one master across all the five. But you can still go for five master orgs. But you cannot have more than one, actually.
Okay.
Got it now. And there are these things we had to discuss later, but since you asked for, I am not answering you now.
As per this example, raw material manufacturing and warehouse are three child inventory orgs, right?
Exactly. Yeah, there are three child inventory orgs now.
Okay, with the master org, there will not be transactions, right?
Huh?
With the master organization, there will not be transactions.
Yeah. Master org, we will not transact it. We will now define the item and then keep it over here. Like a union leader will not work in the plant. He will now have the details of all the employees. He will now represent to the management all the grievances and then he will not work at all. Similarly, the master org, no transactions in the master at all. We will not perform any transactions in the master. We will not perform all the transactions only in the child ledger.
Okay, but still we are giving the, we are associating it to a ledger and legal entity and business unit,
yes,
right?
Yes. It is almost same like any inventory org.
Even in EBS also, you have to create master org as a reference, and then you have to associate the each and every child org to the master organization.
Exactly.
All the items has to be residing in the master org. Then you have to assign the items to the respective child org. This is how it.
Okay.
Who is this? What is your name?
Dinesh. Nana.
Dinesh is saying fine. Excellently explained. Actually, fine. Dinesh has explained.
In EBS, there is only one item master organization, right?
Fusion also one item master. Fine. There is no change as far as inventory is concerned between Fusion and EBS. Almost same, but there are certain differences. Fine. Small differences are there.
Okay.
You have a filter being added here now. Fine. Like that, there are some.
Nana, small question.
Definition organization has come over here. It is not there in EBS now.
Yeah, just a small question. It may happen that my location remains same for the business unit and the inventory org.
Okay.
So how to do in that condition? Business, you were saying we should have a different locations.
Business unit's location has got no functionality, whereas inventory unit's location has got every functionality. Whatever you specify on the business unit is only for information purposes. Fine. So it has got no functionality, whereas inventory org's location has got every functionality. That has got no functionality. Business unit's location has got no functionality. Got it?
Child to locate a control, you didn't give locate a control, it is still there.
The locate a control topic at the time, we will not discuss whatever is there now. Fine. When we talk about locate a control, we will not discuss about it. Okay, fine.
But you said it has to be mandatory, it should not be no locate a control, but you have given no locate a control.
No, you see, this I was reading, if you go and then edit it now, it is not a mandatory one, it is a highly recommended one. Again, I'm telling you, the word of Oracle, fine, it is strongly recommended to have the locator control at the sub-inventory level. Fine, it is strongly recommended. We'll see the problem of it when we talk about the locator control. Fine.
Yes, Nana, but for two, you didn't do this. For two, selected no locator control.
I made a mistake, actually. If you make a mistake, please immediately correct me because I was talking too much and then I'm now doing not properly. Oh, God. It's a mistake, actually. It's a mistake. When I make a mistake, please correct me. It is a strong recommendation by Oracle. Fine. It is a recommendation. Doesn't mean that what happens, you have to only follow that now.
Nana, how about the accounting strings for the organizations? Are
no
they...
accounting in inventory at all. Inventory do not have any accounting at all. Right? It is a different concept when compared to EBS now. Right? No accounting at all in inventory. Supply chain do not have any accounting at all. Right? Every accounting will now take place in costing. Right? It has been pushed over here. We'll be coming to it a bit later now. Right? Those who are going to the ERP, we are discussing about so many advanced concepts. Don't worry about it. Right?
as long as you do whatever you do, you will be up and running immediately. They gradually you will understand all these things, whatever is being discussed. Don't get frightened upon this, right? You'll not say, oh God, I'm unable to understand what is being discussed. It's all bouncing. Don't worry. Fine. If you do everything, whatever I do, you're fit for an implementation immediately. Got it? Fine. Don't worry about it. Fine. Doesn't matter. Any advanced topics you please ask, I will answer it. No problem. Okay. Tell me.
Anasar, as I hear, I have a question here. This is a master org, is the logical one, right?
Yes. Master org is logical. Correct. Very correct.
So it doesn't have any location, right? So why you are attaching the location?
Location is a must actually for every inventory org. Please don't disregard Oracle's recommendation of what happens. You always create one location to one org. No, fine. It's a very important one. Why do you
want? One to one. You cannot have a single location to all the organizations.
Please make a one to one norm. Fine.
One to one, right? Okay.
You do it.
Yeah.
Don't ask. You have to only raise a SRO and ask. Fine.
Okay, this is Oracle recommendation. That's all.
Recommendation, okay. And then if you don't, on the child org, if you do a wrong location assignment, and then here something, this is a child org, fine, whatever you want. And then here, you are assigning it to what? Number one. And then number two. And then we are going to tie also. We are going to perform a tie. And then location organization tie, this is not tied to something else. It will not work also. Yeah, tell me. Yeah, some other questions are coming up.
Yeah, Nana, sir, small clarification, like on inventory org. Suppose we have, based on the warehouses, that many inventory organizations will be created, no?
Exactly. Not only warehouses, raw material source, manufacturing.
So, suppose we have 10 warehouses, so 11 organizations we have to create. Like 10 will be child, 1 will be master. It's like that, no?
Exactly. Okay. Any questions on the inventory org? So the creation of inventory org is complete. Again, there are so many questions which will be answered a bit later. No, fine. Doesn't matter. You ask me and then I will not tell you. Now, we have to tie the org to locations. No, fine. This is a must actually. This is must only for IR, ISO in eBus. In eBusiness, IR, ISO only will be having a tie. Whereas here, every org has to have a tie now. It's a must actually. Go there. Go to the manage locations and go there. So click on
Nana, warehouse and inventory org both are same?
See, warehouse is a specific one. Inventory org is a generic one. Fine. I am a male. I am a teacher. A teacher can be a male or what? Fine. Yeah. Female also can be a teacher. And similarly, okay. What happens? This is an org. This is an org. This behaves like a manufacturing, but it is an inventory org. This behaves like a warehouse. This is also an inventory org. Got it? You go to the managed locations. No, I know that account. I will not go to the managed locations. I'm going to perform a tie now. The managed locations and go there. So click on it. I will not perform a tie now. We are going to perform a tie. Go there. I will not query all the locations then tie it to the respective org. No, I know that you want it. Now go there. So go to this place. The first org. You go there. Click on edit now. Whenever you edit it, you update it. Update will now create one more record so that what happens, we can see which user has updated. That is what CMC is now. And do not follow. If you correct it, what happens, the system will not tell you who has corrected it actually. But if you go for update, one more line in the database will be made with the username who has corrected it actually. So then you can easily catch this guy has corrected it. And update is the best recommendation which HCM recommends actually. And click on update. Go there, click on it. And then you can even give the action reason also and drop it down why you're doing it fine. Relocation or whatever it is, and then give it. Though while report making, it will be very useful now. Fine, what for you have done this now? Fine, that you want. And then you can even change the effective dates and all. Fine, that you want. Date wise, you don't touch it at all. Don't touch the date. Date is a very sensitive one. Whatever the system recommends, just leave it now. And then here, the location I'm going to type the inventory or in the inventory or I go there. G03, and then give it a tab now. I will not put the master over here now. For the zeroth location, I will not put the master. Fine, click on OK now. Fine, that's it. It's not coming. Fine, so it's not done. So click on save and then submit. If you don't have a submit, if you have a submit button, it is a must that you have to submit it now. And then we are normally creating the locations on a common set. It is an RDS object. We have got three RDS objects. One is the location, one is the department, and then one is a job. Remember, all the three must have the reference data set object. Fine. So create on a common set so that any BU can very easily use. If at all the company or the management says that you restrict it to a specific RDS, you do it. Otherwise, you always create every entity. All the RDS objects create always only on common set. Unless otherwise you are being told actually. Click on submit. So click on submit and then click on S, by which this is now completed. So the location organization tie for the master org is completed. Similarly, I'm going to do the tie for the child orgs also. Any doubts?
Nana sir, in future we can convert child org into master org actually. In future, if it is required, client requirement is there, can we create?
I don't know. I will not explain.
No, we are not able to convert the child R to master because child R already transaction will be happening. We are not able to change it.
Oh, if the transactions have already happened, it may not allow.
Yes, we are not able to allow that because as per the standard Oracle terminology, master org cannot able to do any transactions. Okay. Master is a physical one. We are not able to do anything. As earlier, one guy has asked me why you need to assign the location. We need to be as per the Oracle system standards wise. We need to allocate the allocations.
Can do, but we should not. Inventory.
Yes.
Convert master to child like.
You see, these conversions are all you discuss later on. Fine. First of all, understand the basics. Fine. The early basics training. Go that one.
I would suggest please put your all the comments in WhatsApp and later people can answer. Who knows?
Who is this? No. Who is this?
That would be better. Yeah.
Put all your comments on the WhatsApp. I will answer it. And all the training related queries. What happens? You put on WhatsApp or not on the.
Nana, what could be the impact if we are not tying the location with the inventory of?
You should tie. Remember, I'm telling you, you should tie. If you don't tie, I don't know what will happen and all. Fine. There are certain transactions which will fail if you don't tie now.
Transaction will get messed.
Some transactions will fail actually if you don't do. Some will pass, some will fail. I don't know which will pass, will be fine. I'm not worried about it. But there's a problem now.
Nana sir, I guess mainly the internal sales order part, we can't process the order unless we tie the location.
She is saying, who is this?
Surekha.
Surekha is saying that the sales order will have a problem if you are not in tying it actually. Surekha seems to be an expert on order management. Fine. Note down her number and name. Now, fine. You can even take her help.
One more part, the IOTA technician will not work. If I'm not wrong.
Okay. There are certain things which will not work. I'm not sure about it. So Surekha is saying something. And then our one more guy from Delhi is also saying something. Fine. So have a look at it. Fine. What will not work? What will work? I don't know. That's it. So we have done the tie now. Fine, if you want. So now every inventory org is basically logical in nature. Fine. This is a logical org. This is a logical org. This is a logical org. And then we have to create a sub-inventory. Sub-inventory is the physical container of material. So at least every org must have at least one sub-inventory over here. Fine. Every org must have a sub-inventory. Not the master, but the child. Fine. Sub-inventory is the physical container of material. Each and every logical org must have at least one sub-inventory. You will now go and then create it. So I'll now go there. So the navigation for this is what? You go there. I will now go to this place. Fine, go there. Come on. So manage sub-inventories and locators in the task name. Fine, for the take of it and then go there. And then we'll now create the same. We'll now go on the data. Click on the manage sub-inventories. Every org needs to have one this thing. Fine, I will now put G03 and then give a tab. Now. I will now choose not the master, but the child. Now. So master, I'm not going to perform a transaction. Don't create any sub-inventories at all. Fine, sub-inventories are the physical containers of material actually. Coming. So let us now create one thing. Fine. Click on plus now. And that I'm now going to deal on the inventory and procurement front. So I will now create only raw material source now. This training is going to concentrate on inventory and procurement. So I will now make the sub-inventories as what? Raw material stores only. And if it is order management, I will now make it as the finished goods stores. Since I am not dealing on the order management part, I will not do it. So on the inventory and procurement part, I will now make everything as a RMS store now. I will now make it as what? G03 underscore RMS underscore 1. So description also, I now put it on the same thing. RMS1, go there. So go there. Look at the location. If you put G03 and then give it a tab, the tied location will come automatically over there. We already tied it. That will be coming. So we can also give the untied locations also, but we'll be coming to it a bit later on. So apart from that, anything is not required at this stage. Fine, go that you want it. And then give a same and close by this. RMS1 is not done. I given a name, description, and then afterwards, what happened? The location I given, nothing else. Fine, click on same and close. You do exactly as I'm doing. Later on, you will now enhance it now. Fine. As and when we learn more, we'll be enhancing it actually. Fine. I will now go and then click on plus now. I'm going to get one more sub-inventory. Fine. The G03 underscore RMS underscore 2. There are so many advanced topics being discussed. The freshers, please don't worry about it. Fine. If you do whatever I do, you can very well implement a simple implementation. You can very well do it now. You will gradually understand the complexity as and when you learn it more now. So RMS 2 is there. Fine. Click on 7 close on and all this. This much is sufficient.
Though myself was asking questions, but later I realized that it is not good. Better to Nana sir to talk first, and at the end of the session we can ask questions.
Okay,
because there are a lot of people who are getting disturbed. I myself are asking questions, but now I feel that it's not good. Let us not ask questions like this.
This RMS2, you have given location 1. It should be location 2.
Everything. See, both the sub-inventories are in the same org only.
Okay, got you.
They are the same location only. Fine, that will be coming. All the sub-inventories. Sub-inventory wise is not a location. Fine, the org is location. Fine, good question. Fine, go there. I will not change the org. Fine, go there.
Nana, both the sub-inventories are in the same org, same inventory org. Why we and we have already tied the location with the inventory org. Why we are giving the location again?
it was a bug in the previous version when I was working on release 9. If you don't give a location, there are certain transactions which are failing actually. Then Oracle recommended that every sub inventory must have the organization's location. That's what they told me. Probably they might have fixed the bug. I'm not sure about it. Fine. So if they fixed it, this is not required actually. I'm not sure about it, but it is customary to have location specific on the sub inventory. Thank you. I'm now working on this. The inventory org is G032. I've chosen it in the change org and go there. I will not give a plus and then I'm going to create a location. I will not go there. The G03 underscore, what is called? I will not say G032. No, no. I have not made a mistake there. Fine, G032. So, G032 fine is the RMS one. So, G03, I should have given that as a G031 now. Fine, doesn't matter. I made a mistake. So, good. Make a good nomenclature actually. Fine. It's not that it is going to matter, but a good nomenclature is good actually. Fine, the location I'm giving. This, as you were saying, if you give a tab, the second location will be coming. So this may not be required at all nowadays. I'm not sure about it, but it was a problem in release 9 when I was implementing for one of the Kuwaiti company actually. Probably they might have fixed it also. Please mute your mics now. Fine. Please mute your mics. So location, so click on save and close now. Click on plus and then I will locate the second RMS for this one. So G032, it is the RMS underscore 2. Precious, don't worry. If you're able to do whatever I'm doing, you're passing the test actually. For working in a company. So give a save and close now. And then later on, you will learn the advanced concepts gradually. Advanced concepts will be coming gradually. This complete the sub-inventory creation. Sub-inventories are physical containers of material. Every org must have at least one sub-inventory. This org at least must have one sub-inventory for transactions. If you don't have one sub-inventory, we cannot perform any material transactions at all. Sub-inventory is required for material transaction. Org is basically logical in nature. Fine. Org is logical in nature. And then sub-inventories are physical containers of material of org, actually.
One question. Where we have restricted in this sub-inventory, to be restricted on raw materials?
We will now come to that point later. Fine. We'll definitely discuss about it. Fine. Now we jump into HRMS. We are going to have approvals and things. We are now jumping into HRMS. Fine. Go that thing on it. We'll now go to the manage jobs. I'm not going to create a job now. We'll now go and then create a job now. So go to the manage jobs. We are now jumping into HRMS. We are now completing the inventory setups. And then we are now coming into whatever jobs now. Fine, go to the manage jobs.
Nana, before going to that, I have one question. Where is the account associated to the sub-inventories? In EBS, we have cost groups coming to the sub-inventories, right?
EBS has got a lot of accounting in the inventory. Here, no accounting in inventory at all. You can perform. Let us say, if in EBS, if the period is for GL and the inventory are not open, you cannot perform a transaction. Here, it is immaterial whether the GL is open or not, close or not, it doesn't matter. And then you can very well perform transactions in inventory. I attended in Oracle's headquarters in Redwood Shores when I was in Oracle. And then they really told that this is meaningless. That is what they told me. In EBS, we have what's called the accounting period, whatever associated with the GL period. And then only when both are open, you can perform a transaction. The person who has developed this particular software in 2012, they told me very clearly. So we found that this is unnecessary. So we removed all the accounting from inventory. No accounting in inventory at all.
So at sub-inventory level, there is no cost. There is no accounts associated to it.
Having every accounting in cost management. Cost management is a very powerful utility compared to EBIS costing. Fusion costing
everything.
And then every accounting will now take place only there and not on the what is called the execution modules of procurement and inventory and order management. No, nothing. Okay.
No, they have given a lot of flexibility, Nana, for subledger accounting in Fusion, and the costing is the right subledger to handle all inventory related transactions.
I attended this training in the headquarters of Oracle actually when I was an Oracle employee, and then they clearly told that what happens because of certain real advantages, we removed the complete accounting as well as the period cost period concept in Fusion. Fusion do not have any periods. When you want to do, you through the transaction. Don't worry about other modules. Right? Do not get restricted at all. That's what they say.
So, Nana, quick question. So, what about the material transactions? Because if you talk about the generic EBS, we see that the accounts are in inventory level.
Accounting is perpetual. And when you perform the transactions in EBS, the accounting gets hit immediately. Here, it is not so. No accounting is hit when you perform a inventory transactions. Got it?
Okay.
We'll be having a look at it a bit later now.
Sure. Thanks.
Doing it.
So when it is accounted then? If you perform the transaction, it is completed.
4 weeks, I think. After 4 weeks, I think it will be getting accounted. At the time, you'll be learning it now. Not now. So go to the manage jobs. Find out that you want it. Go there. Click on create. I'm going to create a job now. Click on it. Remember, the job, the department, and then the locations are RDS object.
and then you had to put the set of the jobs, the department, and then the locations or audience object. Now, if nobody is insisting upon it, use a common sense so that what happens, it will not have any restriction at all. If at all your top management is saying that you restrict it, what happens, you have to do it. Otherwise, leave it as such, fine. Leave it the common sense. It will be easy for us. Fine. And we really don't need such a security at all. Go to the name. Fine. Go that you want. I'm not going to create G03 underscore junior manager. Junior manager is going to
go there. Nana, why we are creating this job?
Because I'm going to have approvals in purchasing now. So for which job is a must actually. And go there, take copy of it, and then go to the code now. And then the code is a unique.
Nana, can you show other thing like other things in LOB for job set?
In job set, whatever RDS you have created, everything will be coming over. You know? Anybody, when I was creating a business unit, I created RDS, na? Fine. The reference.
Yeah, okay. RDS, yeah, right.
So now the name and then the code. The code is a unique identifier. Always copy the name in the code. Now, fine. Do not have a different code. Fine. It will be confusing later on. So it is always preferable to have the same name copied in the code. Now, in EBIS, it has got a different concept. Here, it is a different. The code and name are different concept actually. Here, that is in EBIS, it is the key flux field. Here, job is no more a key flux field. Remember, Infusion is no more a key flux field. Those who are freshers, please don't worry about it. There are so many high level things which are bouncing for you. Just do it, whatever I do. Fine. That is more than sufficient for you. Okay? And don't fiddle on the dates. Date is a very, very sensitive one on the HRMS point of view. Do not fiddle on the dates. Fine. Whatever is coming, exactly. It must be 1/1/1951. And then just ensure that it is 1/1/1951 on everything now. Fine. Click on next now. Just
Nana, sir, if we assign the RDS, what will be the problem actually in this?
It will be restricted. Whichever BU is having the RDS only can access this job.
Okay. But we need to restrict the this one, no information.
If anyone says restricted, you do it. Otherwise, don't do it. It is not a requirement from supply chain. It is a requirement from the management or the client location. Can say, if you ask you to restrict, then restrict it. Otherwise, put it in a common now.
Okay, thank you.
Full time. What happens? Make it as a full time. Regular. What happens? Make it as a regular. Fine. Go back to want the job. And then level is the important one. This has been really introduced. It's not in EBIS at all. Fine. I will not give 1001. Fine. Go back to want it. Level is not coming. Management level is not required. Fine. These are all the other fields will be filled by the HCM team. If HCM is going to implement it, they will not do it. You will not do it now. Fine. Go back to want it. If HCM is not implemented, whatever I am doing is sufficient for you. I have implemented a project where HCM is not there. There, whatever I have done is sufficient for us now. Fine. Go back to want it. And then you go there. Here, what happens? You are given this level now. Fine. Go back to want it. And that this is sufficient now. Fine. Go there. This much is sufficient. Fine. Give a save and close. If you go to the next now, fine, go there. It will be giving you the details. Evaluation criteria. If you give the next, the profiles. These are not required from a supply chain perspective at all. Fine. Just click on submit now. Whatever I have done is more than sufficient. Click on submit. It will be submitted. The first job is created. It is on 1/1/51. Remember, it should be the same date. That is the only thing which you have to see now. Fine, go there. Give a one down. Fine, go there. I will now go to the code name now. And then go to the G03. And then enter now. Fine. You will now find the job. The junior manager job is created. Fine. Click on create. And then I'll be getting the next job. I will not say 1/1/51 is there. Fine, go there. It is the assistant manager. 03. I will not say AM now. I'm not putting AM. Fine, go there. So take a copy of it and then put on the code now. Paste it over here. Now, fine, go there. So click on next now. Next. And then there is a common set. Fine, go there. Click on it. The full time is the regular. And then I will now give the level as 1000. The next level of a, what happens, the grade wise level actually. This much is sufficient. Give a submit. That's it. 1/1/51 is there. Fine, click on this now. Just see to it that everything is 1/1/51. If you are having a different date, then also you'll have a problem now. Fine, you'll have a problem. Fine, go there. Ensure that the dates are same now. Fine, click on create now. Click on create. It is 1/1/51. Is okay. Fine, go there. Click on it. I will not make a manager now. Fine, G03_NGR. Go there. I will not take a copy of it and then put on the code now. Paste it over here. Fine, click on next. Going over there. And then here, I will not say it's a full time. And then go there. Make it a regular. This much is sufficient. Click on submit now. By which, what happens? I have not completed. It's also 1/1/51. Fine. Go there. Come. All the three jobs which are required for this training is not.
You didn't give level. Yeah,
level. I'm giving G. Level.
Oh God, I forgot.
Level. Manager doesn't have level.
I have no problem. Level. Fine. If you make a mistake, please immediately tell me now. Level is a must. Otherwise, what happens? There will be giving a problem. Level. Whenever I make a mistake, please immediately tell me. Fine. Go there. Come. Level. Long. Click on submit now. There are certain things which are not editable. Actually, fine. I'm going to be very cautious actually.
But Nana sir, this job we need to assign to a particular business unit.
Yes. No, not business unit. Employee actually.
Oh, sorry. Legal.
Employee we are going to associate.
Nana, the start date is something different here. It is not 1/1/51.
Oh, it is not 1/1/51? Wait, we'll not see. 1/1/51 is not there. Oh God, I made a, what's called, this is a problem now. When I make, what happens, an update, it puts the parent date now. Fine. It's a very correct one. Fine. 00/1951. When you're performing an update, what happens? Make a change of the start date now. Fine. So it's not allowing you at all. Okay, I will not show you the problem on this now. I will not show you the problem. So when you perform an update, I should have given the proper data. Effective start date is 1/1/51. Effective end date is this now. Effective start date is 1/1/51. Okay, fine, good. It has to work now. Otherwise, when a problem comes in, we will not see about how to sort it out. Fine. Again, don't make a mistake at all when you're doing it now. Fine. So this is the manager job. The level is
the effective end date should be null.
Yeah, in this case, can we not correct it instead of update? Now that you have already committed the mistake, can we not correct it to set it to 1/1?
Yeah, I will not do the correction fine. We will not see the correction fine.
No, Nana, I don't think this will be an issue because
We face the issue. I will not go the correct now because the dates we face the issue actually. Then HCMT immediately come. Why you are meeting all these things? What are they saying now? Now the date effect is. We will not see this issue. Fine. We will not go there. We will not have a look at the issue. And then when the issue comes in, I will not create one more manager job. Now, fine. I will not do anything. I will not make one more manager job. Now itself, fine. We will not see whether the issue comes. Now itself, we will not see. Fine. Come
down. Now, under the basic deed.
Once again, let me create one more manager job. Fine. Go there. Click on it. I will not create one. Without any mistakes, I will not make it. Without any mistakes, I will not make it. Go there. Click on it. I will not go there. G03. Because my HCM team told me you fiddled on the dates. That's what they told me. Right? NGR, I will not make it as 2 now. So I will not. The second manager, the first manager is now getting displayed. I have not given it. Fine. Click on next now. So go there. Go to the full time. And then here, regular. And then here, whatever the level is 1003. I will not give a simple save now. It's 1/1/51 actually. Fine. Click on submit now. This is not modified anything. I will not see this now. We'll not see what how it's coming. The activity on job is complete. Now we are going to create the departments. Fine. The 37th step is now complete. We'll now go on and create a department.
You have created three jobs, right?
I've created four jobs now.
Four jobs.
Manana, each job has to be assigned to one level only? Or?
Not necessary. Fine. A job is created, but there is no employee at all.
This is only a job. Level. There is no employee yet associated.
You're ready to create employee, no? You're not creating one of the job.
No, here level is only number or based on the level?
Create level, no, fine. Junior manager is one level. The next.
The number. Okay.
Fine. We'll be having a look at it about the functionality of it now. Fine. Click on the node. Now, the next job, the next activity is what? I'll now go on and create the departments. The department is a big one in HCM. It is not a supply chain department, like a mechanical department, electrical department. It is a human capital management department, actually. Fine. Click on it now. So click on create. It's a HCM department, not a supply chain department. G03_ I will not say department one. DPT1. I'm not creating one department. In reality, they will not create so many departments. And apart from that, nothing is required from our side actually. If you as a supply chain man, if you're creating a department, give a name and then click on submit directly. Nothing has to be done. If you click on next now, fine, it'll not go to the department. Plenty of details are there. Don't do anything at all from a supply chain perspective.
Please. Where is this department used at all?
It is used only by HCM. Sure. Human capital management is used.
Okay.
Human capital management is used for them, not by
HCM. Not by HCM.
It is not a key flux field. It was a key.
These are key flux.
All these things are flux fields in EBUS. It is no more a key flux field at all. So click on submit now by which speaking.
Department is
flux field. One is a locator key flux field. One is the account alias key flux field. Those who are freshers, don't worry about it. Fine. They are asking a higher level question. Fine. EBUS has got whereas EBUS has got 7 key flux fields, whereas Fusion has got only 2 key flux fields. One is a locator key flux field, and then one is an account alias key flux field. Remember, no other key. The item is no more a key flux field, and then the category is no more a key flux field in Fusion actually. So click on yes now. So the request is now completed. We only give a name and then give a next and then submit now. Fine. No other thing. If you're a HCM man, you'll do a lot of things now. Fine. This is not a HCM supply chain department. It is a human capital management department. Now, we will now go on and create our positions now. Fine. We will now go ahead and then create a position now. Paste it over here, manage positions now. So go there. You go to the manage positions and then I'm going to create a position. My speed has come down. My delivery speed has come down because of so many questions. It doesn't matter because I'm answering questions because when I have to do a lot of activity by Sunday actually, but it is not going as per plan. It doesn't matter, but it may not be completed in 2 months time. Fine. It may even go for 3 months because we are clarifying the doubts also because it's an education actually. Fine. We are not doing a job, it's education. It doesn't matter.
That's fine,
so click on create. I'm not going to get a position. Click on position.
Position is not an RDS object. Fine. Only job, department, and locations are RDS objects. Position is not an RDS object. Fine. There is no RDS coming at all. Referral data set is not coming. Fine. Go there. I will not put positions. Is BU specific actually. Position is BU specific. You go there. I will not say G03 underscore. I will say junior manager is a generic one. And then junior manager mechanical is specific. So,
Nana, these all setups are related to HCM.
All setups are related to HCM, but if HCM is not licensed and then you have only procurement license, you have to create it.
Fine.
License, you only have to create it. There will not be any HCM team coming over here. Not all.
Okay.
How do you find out if any procurement is licensed? How do you find out?
You see, you have taken a license and then it will not work at all. Right? You have to talk to your, if you're not paid the license, they will not enable it in the back end actually. The particular model will not be available, even though something are available on the front end, but it will not do the transactions on the front end actually, finally. So go there. And then you can talk to the customer success manager of Oracle actually. And then he will now guide you everything. On every implementation will be associated with the customer success manager. And then if you, as a client or as an implementer, if you talk to them, they will now give you more information upon what is licensed and then what all you can do. And then what is the next stage of purchase? Everything he will now guide you. And he is basically mainly for what happens is selling so many things now. So he will now guide you about. Okay, fine. Go there.
I think in the FSM, the list of values depends on your licensing. I
mean, yes, under offering, we'll find it.
I'm not sure.
If you go to FSM and that where you chose financials, that list of values depend on the license.
Okay, fine. Yeah, he's saying that on the list of value itself will not if the license is not product.
Good.
In the offering, we can see.
Yes, go to offering.
Okay, fine.
Not a small question. In the EBU side, you can able to see the license and shared the licenses modules in the user management module. Is there anything something like that in Fusion?
I don't know. I mean, whether we can see the licenses.
Good thing is that you raise the SR and get the
offerings and the FSM area, we will now have a look at it also. So now,
what about the offerings? In the offerings is the place.
We'll come to that. Fine. So the two suggestions have been given regarding the license. We will now come to it and then see it. Okay. So the name is there, code is there. Click on next now. Click on next. Go there.
Now difference in position and job. What is it?
Job is junior manager. Position is junior manager mechanical. Junior manager chemical, junior manager operations, these are the positions. Positions are specific, whereas jobs are generic actually. Got it? Department, I go there, G03, and go there, give a tab, the department becoming. The job, G03, and then give a tab now. You have to get G03, you have to get four jobs. We'll not see whether all the four are coming or not. G03, and then give a tab now. All the four are coming. Sometimes what happens, this one may not come at all. If there is a date conflict, remember. Right. It's coming, and then if you're having a date conflict, it is strongly recommended. My SCM team strongly recommended create all the jobs on same day only. And then if you've got around 30 jobs, sit on one day morning and then create everything, then you will never have a problem at all. That's what they told me. Date is a very sensitive one as far as this thing is concerned. And then if you're not getting the list of values, you may have to create one more job also. It's a very must find of the now given. And then you're given the job location, hiring status is what active, approved. Hiring status is approved. And then it is a single incumbent. That means what? Only one employee can operate this person. Junior manager mechanical can have only one. So if you want to have one more employee or many employees, make it as none. The pooled and shared will be used only by the HRMS team and not by the supply chain team at all. Supply chain team, if it is implementing, they will not choose either none or single incumbent. These two, they will not choose at all. So you will not choose none. None means what? Any number of employees. The full-time equivalent, make it as null. There is only applicable for what happens. You're pooled and shared. So go there. And then the headcount also make it as null. So that any number of employees can occupy this position actually. The junior manager mechanical can be the one which are creating it. So this is the one. So any number of employees can occupy it. Click on it. And then click on submit now. Whenever you have a submit button, we have to click on submit now. So once when you submit it, the concurrent will now run for what happens, they're creating the position now. Is a junior manager mechanical and then once when it is completed, if you go on and query, it will be visible on this G03. You go there, it will be visible on this area. The first position is created. Click on create now. I'm going to get the next one. Positions are BU specific, jobs are RDS specific. Jobs are RDS specific, positions are BU specific. RDS means the reference data set object. Go there, click on it. I will now say assistant manager mechanical. So take a copy of it and then put on the code now. When you're working on it, jobs, departments, and positions on the same day you create now. Fine. There will be some conflict if you're creating on different days. Now. When you're working on Monday or Tuesday or whatever it is, on the same day itself, you work on it now. So
I go there.
What is the name of the concurrent which is running in the background?
I don't know. You just go on and make a check of it.
Nana, one question. You are getting job position at BU level. Can be configured at the LE level?
No. Positions are always at the BU level. He cannot configure at the LE level at all.
No, in that case,
they are specific, and then they are not BU level. They are common across all the BUs, basically. They are common for all the BUs and LEs, whereas positions are BU specific, remember.
No, but none of the concern is that suppose if there are 300 BUs are there within in India, so that means a position which is common across the 300 BU have to copy 300 times.
Good time, good question. I don't know. What he is asking is that India is having one BU and then US is having one BU. He is asking whether I have to create two positions for India and US or not because they are all BU specific. No idea at all. Fine. Again, you talk to somebody who knows this problem. No, fine.
If you are creating BUs,
if my understanding is correct, position is an instantiation of jobs. Basically, if my understanding is correct, see, there is something called a general manager that is a job. And so, say, suppose you have a junior engineer as a job, and then you have four openings for junior engineering engineer in Bangalore, and then say four openings for junior engineer in Pune. So these 4 + 4 are 8 different positions.
Okay, maybe it is an instantiation of a job. That is what you're saying. Okay. Can you
answer this depends upon individual company to company. You cannot say this.
Junior manager mechanical is there, and then you have a junior manager mechanical in the US also. Fine. Since it is a BU specific, I have to create two such positions, or what exactly it is? That is what he is asking.
No, we have to create two positions.
We have to create two positions because they are BU specific.
Hello, you have to create two positions. Okay, fine. That's right. Your question is answered. No, no, no. So given job, no, fine. Location is not required. Manager is not required. Fine. So you log go there, click on approve now. Fine. Type is what? Make it as a none now. And then FT, dissume it out. And then headcount also dissume it out. Fine. So that's it. Fine. Go there. The second position is now is the assistant manager actually. And then click on submit now. And now go and create the final one. That is what? That is for the final one for the day actually. We are now ending it with the no, fine. So with the positions we ended up today. So click on search now, it'll be coming. And then we'll now create the final one now. With the click on plus on create. Go there. It is a G03. Positions are BU specific, jobs are RDS specific, remember. RDS G03, another code, whatever. I will not say MGR. MGR mechanical. So as he was saying, it is an instantiation of a job, then the name may be different. Again, discuss the what happens your HCM team about the naming of the jobs and positions and accordingly do it. I was having a different impression, and then he is giving a different explanation. I'm not very sure about it. I click on next now. So department is what? Go there. G03. And then give it a tab now. It will be coming. Job is G03. And then I will not put the MGR itself now. On the MGR itself, I will not put it. Otherwise, I will not do anything. I will not put the MGR 2 because when I get a problem, I will be finding it difficult now. Because MGR 2 is newly created. I will not choose the MGR 2 now.
When you create the position, the department comes automatically. So how this comes?
Automatically. I only pasted it actually. I put G03 and then give a tab, it came. It doesn't come automatically actually. Go there. I will not make it as approval. I will not make it as what? None. And then remove the FTE and then remove the headcount. And then go there and then click on submit.
So what about the date? It shows
here it doesn't matter now. Fine. Only the job is very sensitive on the dates. Position is not sensitive on the dates actually. It's not showing you the current date, doesn't matter. But job you put as a 1151 now. Fine. There is an implication of this now. HCM team told me so many explanations. I couldn't understand it. I had chore though. Fine. I just left it as a now. Fine. Again, have a HCM along with you. Even if the HCM is not implemented, you have the team along with you and then show it to them about how you have done it. They will also authorize you. Okay, fine. You can go ahead on this one before you do it. On the test instance as well, ask them whether it is all correct or not. Fine. They will guide you on so many factors of this.
So Nana, what is the program which is running in the background? In EBS, we used to have employee field hierarchy.
I will now right click and then duplicate now. Right click and then duplicate. One more tab region is now coming up. Fine, go there. You go to the tools and then here, go to the schedule process. We'll now have a look at it now. Here, nothing is running on the front end here. Right? Nothing is running. It may be running on the back end actually. When you submit it, something may be running on the back end. And then on the licensing part, there are two suggestions given by Dana. Fine, go there. Click on it. People are saying that if you go to the setup and maintenance, and then here one guy is saying if you're not licensed, it will not get listed at all here. That is what he's saying. And then one more guy is saying that what happens if you go to the actions and then go to the offerings, fine. If you have not obtained a license, fine, for a particular project, so that there will not be, say, the product management, you don't have any license.
You don't have, Nana, I'll differ from both of
them. Enabled, actually. I mean, the sales will be disabled. Is it correct if it is not licensed?
No, you can opt it out. What will Oracle will do is they will run the diagnostic and they will give you. They are very smart. They will give you everything.
Not like that. The person is saying, correct, that say example, if you are purchasing finance, you can opt in feature as well for the purchasing and inventory.
No, because
later stage, they will find you that you are using the feature for the purchasing and inventory. Okay. They will not block you from the sales.
Might be that the shade version there.
I mean, shade that's correct, Nana. Oracle will not stop even if we don't have the license.
Because that is a strategy which they use for the attraction. Because, tomorrow if they have to give it, not like EBS, if they don't release patch. Here it is, everything is open. You use it or not, it is like that. But now, start using whatever your agreement is there, that much they will charge. But if you are using anything extra, they will come to know and they will charge you the subscription.
Who is this?
At least in the test environment, they won't stop it. In the production also, you can enable, and later on they will find it out, and then they will
invoice you. Once when they see that you are using it, they will not charge you.
In test, they will not charge, but in SAP, if you are configuring any extra, the system will not allow you to perform any transaction unless the SAP people allow you.
But how it is like an Indian client who say that, no, I have asked only for these modules, but you have
no, see,
Indian client will say, no, I don't know, I won't pay, what will happen?
You are just tempted to use and Oracle will take care of it. It is the licensing part, it doesn't...
Therefore, by mistake, we did any changes, we don't have any license, so it will work?
It will work. Do a subscription and you don't... disable that, so, it will
start. No, basically they run the report in first week of every month. So from that week till next month, you are having a time. Until that, nobody will catch you. So when they'll run again on the first week of next month, they'll easily identify whether your offering is enabled or not. And that is how they'll come to know. And in test instance, they allow you to do so. But if you are performing a heavy volume, then they'll report it out to your management and then they'll ask for the money.
Yeah, that could be their strategy for using new modules.
I share an experience. I did a presentation for a supplier qualification, and later on the client started using, and we found that it is not licensed. So it's a real-time example.
No, that depends upon your business to business. They give you discount offer. That is.
Anna, is session ended for today?
Yeah, the session has come to an end now. Fine. We have completed up to 39, and then the next step of 40 will now begin on next Saturday, coming Saturday at 5:30 p.m. now, India. The session has come to an end now. Fine. It is only, we are not discussing generic points. The activity for the day is now complete now.
Nana, I have a question.
If you have completed step 39, you put it on the, what's called, on the WhatsApp group. So if somebody is having any problem, others will also help now. Fine. You can, or anybody can log in into the instant onto the Zoom, and then they can even discuss amongst each other. If I am not there, what happens, get away. And then try to come.
Can we have the recordings of post-session Q&As coming from more experienced guys so that it becomes easier for freshers to look back at it?
This itself will be post-session. I don't want to have any separate recording. Fine for that. Now, those who are in Japan and Australia can go for bid now. Fine. The activity is now complete now. So for the day...
Nana Anand here. I want to ask one question.
Also, whatever you are talking about. Okay, tell me.
Yeah, so the thing is, we are in implementation phase. I want to ask one scenario, as you have suggested. Suppose one business unit is having, as you have seen in while creating inventory org, that organization do maintenance activity, organization do manufacturing activities. Okay, and what Oracle suggests that if you are doing both in the same business unit, you should create different org. Okay. Now, you are saying that for every org, you should give different location. But the client has given the data for only one location. So by default, you will change one of the locations.
is a very new one now. Fine. I will again repeat what he is saying now. Fine. Let us say in Madras location, one inventory org is performing inventory activities as well as maintenance activities also. So what he is saying is that you have to create two inventory orgs, one for maintenance and then one for inventory activities.
That Oracle suggests, man.
Since the locations are tied, and then we are going to create two locations for these two orgs. I mean, how the conflict of what happens, your stocking and other things will happen. Right? No idea at all. Again, it's a very high level. You won't have to discuss with your managers, basically. I mean,
Nara, this is Satya. You can do in one organization both maintenance, manufacturing, or inventory.
What do you think
that is? It's only a recommendation. Yeah, it's only a recommendation that, you know, you have separate organizations.
Nah, but our business unit can have a trading org also in the same business unit.
Yeah, it depends. You can still do.
But if that the location will be same, na?
Yeah. But if you create inventory org, then the location has to be different. Trading org is also in Madras, and then maintenance org is also in Madras, and then your inventory org is also in Madras. All of them are physically located everywhere same.
Yes.
If you're treating it as a three orgs, then all of you will be having a different location actually.
Nana, can I ask a different question in a similar manner? Yeah. That I sell inventory org can work as a maintenance or trading
manufacturing as well as maintenance also, as well as inventory also.
Is there any disadvantage for creating a single org with maintenance and manufacturing? Is there any disadvantage?
Does it have any disadvantage? What he's asking now?
Actually, the work order which would be created in manufacturing and maintenance, it has numbers. Okay. If you have a setup for different org, you can set the work order numbers for difference. But if you will set up for the same for manufacturing and maintenance, then the work order number would be in the same sequence number, and you won't be segregating. So that is why Oracle suggests to have different setups for different
orgs. Manufacturing and different org for maintenance.
Okay. Yes.
Good. What is your name?
Anand.
Anand is now saying that Oracle's recommendation is what? Have a separate manufacturing and then separate maintenance orgs. So that what happens, your work order numbering will not conflict on this. No, fine. That's what he's saying. But
sir, one question.
A guy from Delhi. Hey, Delhi, I have forgotten your name. What is the name here? Tell me your name now. Fine.
Anand.
No, a Delhi guy. Other guy was asking this question now. Fine.
Vinay.
So Vinay is asking. So the thing is what? Whether to go for different org for manufacturing and maintenance or keeping the same one is still under discussion. Fine. Again, when you land up in the field or otherwise, if somebody knows it more, please recommend on the what's called WhatsApp group. No, good discussion.
Now, what is maintenance? Is it for post-sale support?
Enterprise asset management of EBIS now. EBIS has got EAM module. EAM module
EAM is module.
Maintenance module infusion actually.
Infusion, it is called Oracle Fusion Maintenance for maintenance activities.
Okay.
Is it for post-sale support? Is it?
No. It for machine maintenance.
One quick question,
Nana. So if you are having not having HCM implementation, just a shared HCM, is it okay to just create one generic job and assign to multiple positions?
Very well, do it. One job can be assigned to multiple positions. And then one more guy is saying the position is an instantiation of a job. Fine, again, I'm not having that idea now. Fine, we can even create one job and then do it now. Fine, if HCM is not installed, fine, you can very well have one job and then you can use it for all the positions actually. Good.
Nana, one question. We are talking for the lines. For the lines, there are two different lines. One is for GEO and one is for petroleum product. So can we have two different master organizations?
Yes, we can have. Fine, every LE can have a different master. Right? But only recommended if both the LEs are having the same COA, you only go for only one master. That is what Oracle recommends.
No, but Nana, concern is that if we are allowed to have a common master, so in that case, there is a possibility that the two teams are totally different. And the work.
It's a field decision. Common master or individual master, you make a field. Recommends a common one. But if you feel like having a separate master, they have it. Only thing is, item has to be defined in both the places.
Only concern is that there are certain common items are there which need to be assigned to both the orgs. So in that assigning that in that case.
See, if there are a different master, from that master only you can assign it actually. If you have a common master, we can assign it from the common.
Okay, Nana.
Or we can have two separate altogether separate instances.
Can you again repeat your question now?
If that is the case, we can have one instance for one IMO and another instance for another IMO.
But one license, okay, fine. It's not possible at all. Fine. No, I'm not putting them on. So can you open up your video and then also speak in offline so that whatever you can understand who's speaking?
One last question. Suppose we have already implemented SCM from last 3 years. Okay. Now we want to implement the SCM or the financial part. Mm-hmm. So it is best way to recommend to go to different pod, or can we implement SCM on the same pod?
No idea at all. Fine. At this level, I'm not aware of it. Fine. Can anybody answer Vinay now? Vinay, can you open up your video? We'll now see. You're asking so many good questions now.
Can you repeat your question?
Can you repeat your question now? Vinay, people are asking you to repeat your question now.
Dana, my question is, I am working in an organization where SCM is all... This is a hypothetical question.
Okay.
That we have already implemented SCM from last 3 to 4 years. Okay. We are using Fusion. Now okay. The company says we want to upgrade the existing ERP. Okay, now when we are going to upgrade the existing ERP, there are two solutions. Go to the different pod or go to the on the same SCM pod, we can go for the SCM or financial implementation, or we can go for a new pod, means new instance with new URL.
Uh-huh.
For a same user who is working on purchasing finance and SCM, so he has to log in into two different instances, or it's a kind of from the front end something Oracle will help to fine-tune the login credentials?
No, is it Oracle recommendation? I don't think so. Is someone had contacted Oracle? I don't think they will go for another instance for HCM. You already have a Fusion instance. So yeah. It should be a same instance. And that's why we have an ERP where multiple modules are available. And they can be added as and when the business needs it.
Nana, I will talk to this point to you separately in one-to-one session with you.
What happens this requirement on the future in our WhatsApp group, or even put on the Telegram also, somebody may even answer you.
Okay, Nana, thank you.
Nana, this G03, I have a question on this training. This G03, which you are using, is it one of the company like it is Reliance Petro or Reliance?
Assuming that it is a Reliance Petro or a Reliance Info, I am now using that G03.
One question on business units. Actually, I'm a little bit confused. In R12, we'll create operating unit and all the purchasing setups. Then whatever the purchasing activities we do, that is actually counted at operating unit level.
Yes.
But here you said something like for requisitions, I mean, service provider BU and the client BU.
Only about the service provider and client functionality of a business unit. We have not started the setup of our purchasing at all.
No. I'm just confused.
Operating unit setups only.
No, sir. I'm just confused on that part. I mean, theoretically, I'm asking. One operating unit, I mean, normally purchasing, we do at operating unit level.
Okay, yeah.
So, operating unit setups and purchasing setups. But here, you said two kinds of
things. Operating unit setup at the BU level.
Yeah, that's true. But you said two types of BUs. I mean, for requisitions, service level BU and the other one.
BU and then a service provider BU. This is not available in Fusion, in EBIS actually. Client and service provider BU is a new concept. It's got a flexibility functionality that is being met by your multi-org access control of EBIS. EBIS has got a multi-org access control, which BU itself can be what happens for the payables as well as what happens, it can meet multiple needs actually.
But
it is a very powerful concept here.
So we are we perform transactions at two different business units.
No,
I mean requisitioning and the receiving as the other ones.
Receiving and receiving is a client functionality, and then purchase order is a service provider functionality. But one BU can do all the things also. We can configure that. That is what I'm saying.
Nana, if it is a decentralized implementation, can one BU can see the purchase order of another BU? Is it possible in Fusion?
Oh God, it's a good question, but I don't know. In a decentralized implementation, one BU will be the client as well as the service provider also. Whether they can see others, I don't think so. It's not possible.
Nana, for receiving, you need to go through PO and receive.
Of course.
Yeah. So,
it is the same thing. There is no change in the receiving edge.
So they have the thing to view. So you have a viewing.
Nana.
No. See, receiving is inventory org specific and not BU specific.
Nana, to answer to the question, in EBS, we have MO operating unit, right? A profile option. So that will allow us to view the other business units information as well. So do we have something like that in Fusion?
Yeah, see, we have it as a client service provider functionality that is equivalent to MOAC. So let us say I have operating unit one and then operating unit two. So MOAC in EBS.
Question answer chal rahe hain, zyada experience wale hain.
I am now muted. So I will now first of all answer this question now. In EBS we have MOAC functionality. MOAC means what? When I open the purchase order, I can create a purchase order for operating unit 1 as well as operating unit 2 also. We choose the operating unit and then create a purchase order. That is the functionality of MOAC. The same functionality is achieved by your client service provider functionality also. MOAC setup is very difficult. Here it is very easy actually. I will be showing it to you the client service provider functionality when I am doing purchase orders. It is almost similar, but it is very easy here. Yeah, tell me.
Sir, for creating the job position and department and all, we need to have the subscription of HCM for not, all the models. Not really. Okay.
If you have a purchasing module license, you can very well do the job creation, position creation, employment creation, but I cannot promote an employee. I cannot sanction the leave of an employee. So whatever is HCM related, you cannot do. But the generic one of approvals.
Okay. Thank you.
None of this BU business unit concept is replaced by LE or what?
Here in it is a replacement BU operating unit.
Nana, so I'm getting chart of accounts error. Is your video will support me in resolving that error?
See, I have already 03 you watch. The 03 video you watch, it will not tell you about how to resolve it now. Fine. I was also not having it, but one of my student that he himself has told that this is the error, sir. He just watched.
Okay. No, I can get there. I didn't go through your video, but before that, I just want to check.
It is there. You go through the video, you will understand about how to sort it out and then sort it out on that line section.
Okay, thank you.
Put a message in WhatsApp. Somebody will help you out now.
Okay.
So, Nana, if I don't want to make my business unit as a requisition business unit, only purchase order should be created from that business unit. How can I do that?
Yeah, you just leave it as such. No, fine. If you don't go to the client service provider functionality, it does everything. No, a BU by default, yeah. Don't touch it. It is a client, it is a service provider, it is everything. It is a decentralized implementation actually.
Correct. So in that way, the requisition will be the default every business unit. So because to enable it or to disable it, requisition as a services in that business unit, that functionality is not there.
Yeah.
I believe
this observation is very good. By default, every BU is a requisitioning BU. Right. Only service provider BUs are assigned over there. Right. It's a good observation. It is very correct actually. Every BU is by default is a requisitioning BU also. Right. There is no such thing which is going to stop you from creating a requisition by default. Right. Everything can be behaving as a client BU also, and that's good. And then service provider can be restricted actually. Right? That is the only thing. Right? Service providers are purchase orders. For requisitioning, every BU can raise a requisition, can make a demand actually. Good observation. Yeah, fine.
Sir, we can disable it from ASEAN business unit business function, right? From there also, if you unselect it, we cannot create it, right?
We will now come to it a bit later. No, fine. We will now come to it a bit later. How to disable a particular BU from requisitioning? I will now come to that a bit later.
Nana, one question. When we were creating inventory org, under location, we had an option of as an internal or external.
It's for what? For the CRM modules and not for the supply chain modules. So just like in EBIS also, we have the employees are external actually. It is the same functionality of EBIS now. If you make it as external, fine, all the employees are external. For example, I am from Reliance. Fine. And rather, I am from TCS. And then my team is now sitting in Patal Ganga of Reliance and then doing it now. So we will now, Reliance company will now create an org called TCS org, in which what happens is they will now make the employees as external actually. For Reliance, TCS employees are external. So this doesn't come under supply chain actually. It is a CRM activity. External.
Okay, so CRM. So no material related transactions won't happen, right? In external.
It will happen, but it is again for Oracle retail and for a depot repair. And there are so many other functionalities. We'll be creating an org with an external employees, not for supply chain actually.
Okay, and another question is, you were mentioning RDS many times. Can you just tell us more about that?
I told you, no? when you swipe a credit card, if you're going for 25,000 or 50,000, it will ask you an additional security of what? OTP or otherwise a mobile number also, apart from PIN. This is called
No, related to this only, I am asking. Like, is there any equivalent to RDS, anything in EBS?
No. RDS is basically a SaaS compliance. When software is SaaS compliant, you need to have an RDS. Otherwise, what happens? You cannot operate at all. License will not be given to Oracle at all to operate as a SaaS, as in the cloud. So to operate the cloud, what happens? You have to be SaaS compliant. SaaS compliant is not asking for the restriction, and then you're doing it.
But we restrict the RDS, sir. How the supply chain management will work? Because this is very, very tough, no? Because we are transferring the IRSO and all one view to another view in the same organization. How it will be? Why they are giving the option RDS actually?
Oracle supply chain do not want the RDS at all. But it is forced by the SaaS model. To make it as a SaaS compliant, they have introduced the RDS. And then you're supposed to have it. No other go. They say the security is required. And so to bypass it, they have made a common set now. If you make it as a common set, it is all bypassed. RDS is bypassed, actually. The security is bypassed. Okay. That way you have to operate.
What are the components of the RDS which you mentioned?
RDS is a reference data setup that I already explained you there. When I was creating a BU, what happens? I created RDS and associated the BU basically.
Okay.
So one question regarding inventory.
You can even make a BU as a common set also.
If you so make Nana, it, somebody has asked that one
security is bypassed.
So Nana, somebody has asked that whether one can view the purchase order of another business unit or not. So that can be controlled by the RDS, right?
Again, that sort of a cross functionality.
No, I don't think so.
That is why data security.
You said RDS is only for location, department, and job. But this
RDS is for location, department, job, and then it's got a lot of functionality, like payment terms, and then the customers, and other things. So many RDS objects are there from financial perspective.
But the RDS plays an important role in payment terms, like
So financials has got a lot of importance in RDS. Fine, and again, one PO of one BU can be viewed by other BU or not. I don't have much of an idea.
I guess it can be controlled through the procurement agent. I'm not sure 100%, but maybe procurement agent.
It is done by data security. Sir, there is something called managed data security, right? Where you give that role to business unit.
Once again. Raj has given a suggestion. Let us now experiment it during procurement. Now, fine. We will now make him as a procurement agent of another BU. We will now see whether we can view it or not. Fine. Let us go to.
No, it should be possible.
In procurement agent, there are three options like view in the document part you're talking about. No, I think.
We will now experiment it during purchasing. Fine. Raj, you remember it and then ask me. No? Fine.
When you're doing
one thing, Nana. We are not configured the user based on the BU, correct?
Of course, yeah. BU user is not configured based upon the BU.
Then we can see the other BU's BU as well.
It may not be visible at all. Fine, that's what I'm saying. It may not be visible. As Raj was saying, if you make the employee as a procurement agent of another BU, correct. Then we can see it. That's what he's saying. We'll now experiment it. Okay,
then only we can see. Yes, that is true.
Maybe. We will experiment it. When you put all the suggestions, you know, what happens? Do an R&D while we are doing the procurement actually.
One query on inventory or creation.
Tell me.
Creation of these jobs, positions, and department is only for.
Deepan was asking one question. Let him complete it. Deepan, come on.
Sir, so during creation of inventory org, in EBS, we used to have receiving option kind of setup, like for receipt numbering and all. Yes. So do we have the same setup in Fusion also?
In Fusion also. Right? Whatever setups we have on the receiving options, we also have the same setup, but it is in a different place actually. Right. The functionality is same actually.
And what about this approval process, this job position and approval groups and all?
In EBIS, we have only the job level and then the what is called your supervisor level and then the position level.
Here position level.
Position and supervisor level. Here, there are six different types of approvals are available here. And then AME is not there in Fusion and then it has been bypassed. And then here, the approval engine is really a very powerful engine when compared to EBS. Approval is really powerful when compared to EBS.
This BPM, right?
It's got an excellent enhancement when compared to EBS, actually. Inventory is not so. Procurement has got an excellent enhancement when compared to EBS.
So that will be discussed, right? Later in training.
We will be discussing about it. Right?
Okay.
So,
Nana, this multiple locations, for example, if Reliance Petro has operations in Mumbai, Chennai, and Bangalore, okay. Is three business units will be created or it will be a single business unit?
We have to decide based upon the functionality. This will be decided by the top management team now. Whether they have to go for one BU or multiple BUs, they will decide actually. Because financial accounting is very, very important when you go for depending upon the financial accounting, they will now decide how many BUs you want.
So the same
thing, decision making, even the supply chain team will also be participating in it, and depend upon the company's policy actually.
But the same country also, they can have multiple business units also.
Depending upon the need, they will now configure multiple BUs or single BU. Fine.
Now coming to these jobs, positions and departments, is it only specific to approvals?
Yeah,
or it has any functionality?
Supply chain is concerned, it is specific to approvals, but as far as human capital management is concerned, it has got lots of approvals.
Okay.
Did you say something about the reference organization, Nana sir?
No, not yet. I have not yet discussed at all about this.
No.
So you will do it or it is in the extra time only?
No, do it and then I will now show it to you.
No, on this, Chennai, Bangalore and Mumbai. So is it that legal entity will be one legal entity and but the business unit will be based on the business, right? Management.
How many LEs, how many BUs, how many inventory orgs is again a big decision now, right? Based upon the requirements gathering, the top management will not decide the structure. How much?
But legal entity should be only one, right? How can we have India?
Reliance Petro will be one legal entity. Reliance Info will be one legal entity. Fine. Everything is a company. Legal entity is a company which reports to the government actually. So right. You'll be providing the profit and loss statement of every LE actually.
Correct. Okay.
Nana, this is Dipankar. So I think I will have time to
Okay. Fine. Dipankar is a good man. He knows a lot of things. Note down his name in the WhatsApp and then communicate.
Yeah.
Announce all of us. Please announce him as your friend actually.
Yeah, I think questions are coming like completely like fire.
Rapid fire. Rapid fire. Machine gun. I found it so difficult to ask a simple question. There are so many questions.
Yeah.
So overwhelming. Nana, hats up to you. Nana, hats up to you. You have nerve. You are answering so many questions.
Yeah, I think Nana.
Nana, one thing. None of the instructors, right? They won't allow multiple questions during the training. That's what I see in other thing. But you allow it. But the problem is, we have 200 participants and different. Different level of knowledge. See, even we can see one use abusive language after the end of the meeting. So it is like, but the thing is, I think better we can reduce the number of questions during the meeting. See, so it will not be, no, we cannot do that, but to some extent, whoever is asking,
I agree,
should reduce it.
Right, okay, inventory,
yeah, means,
I don't, what I must restrict the days at all. Fine. Let us now learn. Fine, I'm also in the learning path. Whatever I know, I teach you. And then somebody knows something, whatever, they are going to teach us. Fine, it is a mutual learning actually. Fine.
But that is fine. As long as you say that you can extend it to 2 months, 3 months and 4 months, then it will be better.
No, that is fine. But I am worried about the level. Beginners. Beginners are actually overwhelmed. See, experienced people are understanding the questions. But the beginners are in really tough position. They are not understanding anything.
Very difficult.
So have some respect for them also.
I do. Fine. If they do, whatever I do, they are up and running and then they can even join a company and then start to work at a lower level actually. That's what I mean. Beginners, you let them practice whatever I did. That is more than sufficient actually. They will gradually understand all these questions. Whatever questions are there, mine is already recorded and so they will gradually understanding it.
Yeah. So Nana, I think
if somebody... better to compare between EBS and cloud, then it will be understood, will be faster.
It is more enhanced, but every functionality of it is not being brought over here now. Fine. It's not actually coming and then it will now surpass EBS basically over a period of time.
Nana, regarding this inventory locations, there were two values, internal and external. Mostly we use internal, but for contract manufacturing, when we like Fusion offers one feature, like if we do contract manufacturing where we completely outsource the manufacturing activities to a third party, so then we define a location and that organization will be categorized as contract.
I now muted all of you. Now you open up on the mic and then speak. I muted all of you. Dipankar, you can now talk.
Yeah. So what I was telling is that location of type external can be greatly used for any contract manufacturing process where we define one organization and we associate one location and that location is of type external. And that is where we outsource the complete manufacturing activities to an organization which is attached to an external location.
Yeah, I'm not aware of it. Fine, it's a new one. My new concept is saying Fine. Okay, when I am learning contract manufacturing, I will now look at it to this problem of this issue also, right? To make an inventory org as an external, and then I will now try to learn it actually. Fine. I mean, to learn fully. Fine. I have already learned partially, but I have not learned it fully. I'll not do it. Thank you, Deepankar.
Nana sir, what is the use of creation division actually? You are not created the divisions.
Division is optional, and then my financial consultant says that I don't want to have a physical division, and then they always incorporate the division in the chart of accounts actually as one of the segment, because that is how it happens in EBIS. So they are habituated to EBIS practicing, and then even though we have a physical division, and I have never I was participating on 7 implementations, and none of them they use the divisions at all. Division is okay. Not used. They say that we will now make it as a segment of the chart of accounts. We don't want to have a physical division there.
Okay, but we no need to create the division, right? You can directly. You can.
No need, but if you want, you can have it.
So, but in Fusion, the option is there, right?
Yeah, Oracle has provided a functionality of what happens below an LE. We can have a division actually. Fine, one division below an enterprise. Below an enterprise, we can have a division, and then every division can have one LE also.
Okay.
And Nana, one thing I want to share here, someone is asking what are the license which you are having in the Fusion, right? Mm-hmm. There is two options to get the details. One is we have to raise the SR, and another one is when you are trying to raise a SR for a separate concern, for example, procurement, right? We have to select the list of values in the, whenever you are selecting the list of value, it will populate what are the license which you are having, and it will restrict if you are not.
During the time, you are saying that what are the licenses which are available? Okay, okay, fine. Yeah,
yeah, that way we can find it.
Okay, that way also we can find it. Good observation by Surya. He is saying that when you are raising a SR, just make a dummy SR. You don't submit it, and then at the time, what happens if you drop down? It will not tell you what are the licenses which are available for you. Right? That's what he is saying. Good.
And Nana, this I have seen, I have experienced. This would be a very common interview kind of questions. Mm-hmm. Difference between operating unit and business unit. I think people were rightly asking in the questions, and it is very obvious that they need to know.
Comment on this now. I will now upload into my web space actually. If you have,
yeah, you're asking difference between EBS and Fusion like that.
This is a very good question actually. Operating unit and business unit. We just have to know that operating unit and business unit more or less same, but it is enhanced further. The same terminology is enhanced further, and business unit is capable of handling this kind of service provider models, and then this is the main difference actually. So people, if they know that business unit is only an enhanced term of operating unit, which is capable of managing multiple like this kind of centralized or shared model kind of concepts. Mm-hmm. So if they can satisfy this answer to the interviewer, then it would actually like give them the satisfaction.
Any documentation on this, Anna, please send it to me. I will now circulate amongst everybody. I will upload in the web space. Good.
Anna, one question on the schedules part. So I guess in schedule we had time schedules. We had something quarterly type, and it had some 4 weeks, 5 weeks, something. So how do we actually read it? What does that mean? It monthly, 4, 5.
13 periods are monthly has got effect only for the planning module. Planning has got 3 modules: one of the demand planning, one of the supply planning, one of the sales and operations planning. So they only will be very much what happens in need of the choosing of the quarter type actually. Otherwise, supply chain will not work on any type actually. It will be working on a 24/7. Right? It is not having any restriction at all. So when you learn planning, you will understand it to take great action, because it is a bucket. So week is the only bucket by which we can make a plan. Month is not a bucket. Week is only a bucket. So for which they need a 4-4-5 or 5-4-5 or something like that.
Okay. So what does that mean, 4, 4, and 5? So
4, 5 means what? The first 2 4 weeks. Let us say you are now working on January 1st to December 31st as your financial year. So there, if you put the 4, 4, 5, January 1 to January 28 is month 1. Right? January 29 to next 4 months 4 weeks is month 2, and then afterwards
okay. 5,
month 3.
So okay.
Based upon these weeks actually, and not your calendar months actually.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Thank you.
Any other doubts? Any other questions?
No, I'm facing that deployment error. So can we do it tomorrow?
I'll try. Otherwise, I will not combine. You try. Watch the 03 record and then try to correct it. And then put a message on the chat. We will now come again now in tomorrow morning. Okay. You try your level best, because diagnostic capability you have to develop now. Anand?
Okay, so tomorrow morning, if not, then you will help me out.
Huh?
Tomorrow morning is possible to connect for this.
Yeah, I will be here somewhere. No, fine. You first make a try. Must make an
attempt. Yeah.
If still unable to do, what happens, you put a message on the Zoom and then the WhatsApp, we will again come on Zoom and then we will not try to find out the problem actually. You try first of all, and then otherwise, if it's still not possible, then we will all jump in now and then try to solve the problem.
Okay. Hi, sir. Hi, Nana, sir. This is Ganesh.
Tell me.
Sir, as I'm from official network background, I understand that this cloud got amalgamated with HCM, financials, supply chain management.
Okay.
And people are very much worried about it.
Yeah, yeah.
So many questions and queries. I'm trying to get bits and pieces of what you're trying to say and following that.
Yeah, yeah.
So, yeah. And this, am I right? Like, this is all like amalgamated in,
of course, naturally. JD Edwards, PeopleSoft, then other bought out products. Fine, all the futures have been amalgamated into Fusion actually. So, Ebis, JD Edwards, PeopleSoft, etc., Primavera. So, they have brought in every future, and then they found that whichever is good, they have put it on Fusion actually.
People are like very much freaked out actually.
Yeah, see, it's a gradual learning process. If you're a fresher, you have to do a lot. No, fine. Learn whatever I teach, and then afterwards, on that basis, I am now giving you a very strong footing. And then, based upon the footing, you start to explore the system. You'll understand a lot. My students know much more than what I know because they got a base now. Fine. The base is now there. Afterwards, based upon this, they are building, and then they have gone. They have now made empires actually on this.
Yeah, thing is like we need to follow first step.
Yeah, first. Exactly do whatever I do, and then later on you will understand that this may not be a good, and there will be a better method to do this also. Fine, you will identify it, and then you fine tune it.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Nana, one other question. I heard you mentioning SAP versus Oracle yesterday. Yeah. How come SAP is not modular, but still you found that it is very good for implementing?
I was an end user of SAP for more than 4 years now. I still hail SAP as the best product. It is very easy to configure. Fine. From a consultant's viewpoint of view, it is beautifully configured actually. Fine. It is now like what happens, step by step. After you do this, after this, here it is not so. You go randomly here and there and then do all these things. No, there it is not so. So you create first of all an LE, and then afterwards it will ask you, you tell me what is the ledger, and then afterwards, step by step question sort of a thing, it is now coming up there. It is easy to configure, and then you will not miss anything at all. Here, if you miss any simple setups, then something may not work at all properly. That is not so in SAP. Really love it. I love the product because I was sitting when it was way back in 1995, I think. At the time, the SAP team was there in our company, and then they were configuring it. And then I was sitting along with them and then watching it because I was a customer actually. So they allowed me to sit and then watch. Beautiful. I really appreciate the product. Way back in 1995, I'm telling you. Beautiful product. I love it. Oracle is still not attained that much of a flexibility in configuring it actually. Even though functionality is there, everything is there, but here you're bound to make mistakes. Fine. There it is not so. Mistake levels are very, very less actually there.
Yes, in the Oracle, it will show only error and it will not say where is the error exactly, what we need to do the setup. Again, we have to go and we have to share with the error details and all. We have to search in the Google. Why it is...
Fine. It is not so in the case of SAP because I was an end user for more than 4 years. I love the product. Even though I'm teaching Oracle, I hail SAP only.
Nana, in manufacturing domain, how much acceptance for this Fusion product?
Even in Ebis also, it is not having much of an acceptance because when I was conducting a training on Ebis, I had one JD Edwards guy came in and then attended the training. He's a useless product. That is what he told me. He's saying that JD Edwards manufacturing is excellent. That is why Oracle has purchased it and then they have now incorporated the features of JD Edwards in Fusion. That's what they say. But I'm yet to go through that module fully. Manufacturing is always so fine as far as Fusion is ERP, Oracle is concerned. Also. Oracle is very strong in financials and then procurement is very good. Inventory is now matching the needs of the industry actually. Fine. One by one, it's all coming. They're saying that we are now observing the market and then bringing in more and more features. Over a period of time.
Manufacturing is far behind.
Yeah, manufacturing is way
behind. OPM was having so many features in R2L, but this manufacturing doesn't have anything yet.
Exactly.
Almost anything.
It is not at all OPM actually. Fine. Or process manufacturing is very bad in Fusion actually.
Sir, what about order management? They have implemented.
The order management is a very tough one actually. We had a big problem because the JD Edwards team dominated when I was in US in Redwood shows. The developer told me, he is a Tamilian, and then I was saying, Ray, are this Bekar Loga, majority were JD Edwards, the development team. So they brought in the JD Edwards futures into it, and then they messed it up actually. Even advanced pricing, you need to have no technical actually. So that is not easily possible. See, writing a buy one, get one free, you need to code it. It's really very difficult now. The distributed order orchestration itself is technical actually. It's powerful, but if it is a technical one, how come a functional consultant can go on and implement it? It's very, very difficult.
Have they implemented all the cycles like the drop ship and back to back?
Everything is there. Whatever their name is, everything is there.
Okay.
But the methodology is slightly different. And then it is not what happens. Every implementing company will not find it fine. The TCS is going to implement order management. They have to have a very strong team which knows the technical aspects of ADF and Java. Otherwise, they will find it difficult to implement it actually.
Sir, for regular sales order management, we need technical.
That is not it. For a regular normal sales orders and all, it's okay. That is not technical. But the advanced levels are technical actually. Tell me.
One of our clients, they are using the order management actually, procurement, inventory, and order management.
Okay.
So for order creation and return process only, they are using. But comes to in procurement, there is budgetary control and everything.
Mm-hmm.
So I know, but up to that part, when you know, this order creation and troubleshooting and everything, but rest of that, I didn't involve in even in this one dropship and back to back and all.
Good. Fine. That's fine. So if there is any other questions, we will now continue. Otherwise, we will now call it a day, actually.
Thank you, sir. We had an excellent session today. Okay. Thank you very much. Bye.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Good day. Bye. Good night.
Thank you all.
Bye. 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 Bye.
Nana, sir, here we don't have internal requisition concept, right?
Yes, it is there. But it is not required. Right? We will now come to that in procurement. IR is there. Right? But it is not required. That is what Oracle says. Right? Only on a specific stage, you need IR. That is what, if a customer wants an approval, then they have to go for IR. Otherwise, IR is not required. This is called IRTO infusion. And then there it is IR-ISO. Right? Here, IR is replaced by TO, transfer orders. And then Oracle strongly recommends you to go for a transfer order instead of IR. But if the customer says even internal transfers needs an approval, then you have to go for IR route. IR route, you need a GOP license. If you don't have a GOP license, you cannot get IR.
Okay. Thank you.
Good, then fine. Bye for now, and then we'll all meet on Saturday. Good. Bye.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you.